Hello, Internet. I'm Nick, and this is Civ 6. So, this is, I believe, the second episode of this particular playthrough. I say it, I believe, because I haven't actually played this for a week. I've been kind of distracted by other computer games, but I've come back to this save. And let's just see if I can remember everything that's happened last time. Why can I not scroll? Is that really the limit to the scrolling? I do not remember not being able to scroll out more than that. Anyway. So, we started in Kyoto, obviously, and we've settled Sendai last episode. Annoyed both green Cleopatra. Well, light green, lime green Cleopatra, key lime Cleopatra, and red Cleopatra. With our placement too close to them, but we won't be placing any more cities that way, so they're not going to really get angry. We discovered that there was this iron here. We kind of thought about whether to put another city there or just take Jakarta, like let Jakarta get that iron and take Jakarta, or maybe Egypt's going to take Jakarta first and then we take Jakarta off them, who knows, or one of the Egypts. So to our south we've got Orange Egypt, so our best relationship currently is Green Egypt, and that's unsurprising given that they're a distance away. Actually, that's different Green Egypt. This Green Egypt, which I think is original generation Egypt. I think that's the normal Egypt colours. No, that's not, because... I think normally Egypt's blue and yellow. Or were we going to find OG Egypt somewhere? Anyway, whatever's the case, dark green, yellow Egypt, green and gold Egypt is the only one who hasn't denounced us. Although those guys haven't denounced. Anyway, we'll deal with it. What is our defense situation? We have not enough units to defend, however, we do have a lot of jungle. A lot of rainforest around and rivers. It's very defensible terrain and it will take them a while to get to my borders, so I should have more warning than I would if I was in the middle of some plains. Is that enough time to build up an army? Probably not, if they were to suddenly start attacking me. And sometimes things like that do occur, because I've noticed in a lot of computer games, like I don't know about Civ in particular, but a lot of computer games, it's almost like when you load a save later on, the AI suddenly kind of reassesses the situation and then makes some decisions. Again, maybe even randomly decides, like flips a coin whether to attack you or not. So that can lead to a sudden dramatic change in diplomatic policy to what they were kind of the way that they were dealing with you prior to you saving and exiting the game. So we'll find out if that's the case in this. But yeah, not enough defensive units, but Kyoto can quickly bang out some defensive units with all of their production. We'll get Sendai up and running and potentially make another city. That would be a tempting place, actually. More chocolate, and some horses, and some iron. Do we have horses anywhere else? That doesn't really seem to be horses up for grabs anywhere else. Brussels has horses. But anyway, let's snap to it. Oh, we just got our trader last turn, so it's still... I mean, yeah, last episode, so it's plunking down roads as it goes. Okay, which one is this? Okay, this is... it looks a lot more green and goldy up there. It, well, when you click on her, it's... Oh, I don't know, actually. What the hell? What the hell? Okay. That isn't very nice of you. Evidently, I should have bought that tile before they jumped in and stole my stone. I think I'm gonna have to, like, buy the spices, because otherwise I'm not gonna get them. So... do I have enough gold to do that? Actually, I probably do have enough gold to do that. Do I have a government that's... don't have the... Oh, I could wait till early empire and then swap in... Oh, I could... yeah, I could swap in land surveyors when I get to that. That's 4 turns, though. So what would I be saving? Like... 12 gold, 12 plus 18, oh yeah, oh, how stupid, 2009, yeah, so like 30 gold, is it worth 30 gold? Let's just do this thing. No one's taking my spices. Like, no one's taking my resources. Evidently they've taken my stone now, but we will let that serve as a lesson to us to not let them take things. And on that note, I'm not letting them take my hills. The flatland's probably okay, but it's just, well, I could close them off at the pass on that mountain. Head them off at the pass on that mountain, so they can't expand past there. That could be, that would be the really kind of xenophobic thing to do, in a way. I think we're okay. This city may not exist soon, because if we go to war, I may just destroy that city, but then everyone's gonna think I'm a dickhead for destroying a nice city. But they asked for it, essentially. Don't know which Cleopatras those are, but anyway. Maybe that builder was even getting built to get that stone. I forget. Past Nick made some decisions. I don't remember what those decisions were. Okay, yeah, getting dissed again by which Cleopatra? Oh, her color's there? Okay, let's actually see. I'll click on. No, they all look the same. There is no visual significance as to which one is which, apart from how nasty they look at us. Okay. Karnak. There's lots of new cities, apparently. I can't see those, so that's all, like, it's okay, as long as they're not settling right next to me, though, it's all fine. Now, I might want a settler, but on the other hand, I can't really do that. Could build an encampment. Now, what is our plan in terms of districts? What, like, we want to make a hex of districts, because there's an achievement for doing that, essentially. And that's probably going to be the best place for our hex of districts. So then it becomes a question of what districts do we put in that hex of districts. Now, to the north, obviously your holy sites and your campuses would go near the mountains. Whatever goes in the center is going to get a +6 bonus, so that is what we most want to buff. Now that, like, an industrial zone could be the option there. And I apologize if I already I know I discussed this last time. I apologize if I made a decision then and you're now witnessing me make the same decision process simply because I've forgotten what I'm doing. Maybe I should just write it down. But the industrial zone would be the prime candidate in order to get a lot of production, and also the factory would then be in between the two cities and buff both cities. So I mean, obviously, like, both cities can put their industrial zones right next to each other. But what else would we want? Not really. We don't really need gold so much to put that in the center. Also, the adjacency bonuses for a commercial hub are, like, a lot better in terms of external things. I'm not really going to get that. I'm only going to get the adjacent river. So a commercial hub just needs to be on river. Actually, if you put the commercial hub there, you get +2 from the river, and then you'd get all this. Yeah, so if I really wanted gold, but I don't really think, like, while gold is useful, gold is not something I really need to push, and also there are good alternative options to get gold, while production is something that you really can feel limited by. Now, all of those are special ones. So you've got the theatre square for culture. If I ever do build a wonder. So I don't think we want... obviously we want campuses, because we're going after a science victory, which really requires building some things, but teching up to get to the position where we can build those things first. So campuses and industrial zones seem to be the highest priorities, and then you've got some other things. Theatre Square, so we don't fall too far behind on culture, because I think that could be a trap that we could fall into. Encampments, just simply for the purposes of getting units, yes, we're going to have to remember that we're going to have aqueducts going on, and... there's entertainment complexes that I'm not really that... Firstly, they don't get adjacency things, so... they do not seem that important. Oh, spaceport, that might be required. Okay, let's just simply Okay, so that can't be built on hills, so I just need to remember that I need to have a place for a spaceport. But the thing is that I could just plonk a spaceport down somewhere else, like there, or wherever. Maybe on that marsh. Or here if I get that tile. Or there. So I would think there seems a logical place for a campus, because probably we'll have at least three districts adjacent to it, and potentially another one there. Yeah, I mean, even that could be okay there because of the mountains, but that seems more like a holy site just for the mountains. So campus there. Well, actually, Sendai could put its campus there. So both, yeah, that's probably a good strategy for that in terms of that. And then just build theater squares. We'll work it out, but the industrial zone is probably going to want to be, if we went like that with the industrial zone, so Kyoto's industrial zone is here and Sendai's industrial zone is there. If we go with the two campus strategy thing, then that industrial zone is still going to have like four districts adjacent to it, so that's pretty good. And then we could probably build some other districts around here, so that seems all okay. And in fact, if we put the spaceport there, then that's good idea. Holy sites here and here, maybe, because it's not as important to get this faith. For what is, actually, that's a good point. We have no hope. Is that, am I correct in thinking that? That we have no hope in getting a religion. It's potentially the case. But actually, if we should probably try to push for a religion as soon as I've got enough defensive units. That actually seems like a good idea, because I really don't want to be in the situation where yet again I don't have a religion. A lot of other people have their faiths, and then I can't safeguard the world from an enemy religious victory, because I just don't have a stake. I don't have a religion to push to negate other people's religions, because otherwise I'm going to have to like make missionaries of both sides to try to keep the balance, and keeping the balance is annoying. Or did I actually? Maybe I might have disabled religious victory. Actually, this is the way to know. Yes, okay, disabled religious victory. Okay, so I don't need to worry about that, but it'll still be good to have a religion. Two science isn't actually that great. What's our pantheon? So I don't really want to get rid of my marshes for now. But I guess that's just an early game bonus that's useful. Well, it was useful for Kyoto. It's not really the best. Anyway, outcome of that is, if I was to have an encampment, it would probably go there or there. Simply because then that can contribute to the adjacency bonuses, but it doesn't actually get anything from adjacency, so... And right here is in some way that... I'm probably not going to build anything in those tiles, so I might at some point. Like any districts. So that could provide a foundational kind of thing. So I could just buy that tile and plonk down my encampment. On the other hand, probably a theater squares. Like that's actually going to have adjacencies, so probably I should put the encampment somewhere that's not going to have any adjacencies. On a terrible tile that is useless. Oh, and farms. Farms get the whole farm bonuses. So I really do want to put it somewhere that's not being used. But then that's a mining. Oh god, so many decisions. Because, yeah. We could mine there. That is. It's just rainforest plains, but. Farms get the whole farm thing, like a triangle of farms is going to give bonuses to each other, so that would be the ideal triangle of farms. Do I need food that much? Maybe not. What is our food situation? There is a lot of food. I probably can survive without. Why did I think that this was a... Why did I think that... Yeah, anyway. That's probably the best position for the encampment there, but it is a marsh, and the marshes are useful for us. Anyway, let's push out some. Like, we do actually have the time to encampment up. Let's just plonk it down there. That offers a defensive advantage as well, because that's one of the few flat lands that's, offers an, yeah, so that wouldn't have had a defensive bonus otherwise. If we'd put a plant. Go there. Yes. I think that's what I want to do in terms of that. Oh. Do I have enough gold to do that? I will have enough gold next turn, so let's wait for next turn. That's not patronizing. Okay. Oh, we could actually bring in the land surveyors now. If we wanted to. But maybe we shouldn't. Yeah, I don't actually think we're going to get anything that advantageous from that. Now, what was our plan? Obviously get the science things going. Go along the science path. But otherwise... Well, we could... We probably should get irrigation got up and running, because now we have all these resources in our sites. Maybe astrology, however, for the holy sites. That's an argument. Or we could just be agnostic to religion, because we have disabled religious victories. Just not care about religion at all. And I guess, yeah, I mean, the thing is, we've disabled religious victory, which is very much a cheating thing and a way to make things easier. So we should actually take advantage of that ability to disregard an entire aspect of civilization, because playing on deity difficulty level, we need to take any advantages we can have. Now, to continue down towards political philosophy, we want a state workforce. Oh, and yeah, and obviously we need to build a district, so it's good that we're building that encampment. Yeah. Let's do that greedy thing that we were discussing. Oh, prices have gone up. I guess in this situation, I'm actually gonna swap that out. Just for now. Savings. Do I get any advantage from this? I'm gonna say yes. The thing with religion is that I've actually realized that one way to stop religious victory is just never let anyone into your borders. Next, go there. Okay. They're moving up units. I think I should. Oh, really? Wow. It's good. Oh, okay. So I do actually really need those spices right now. Can I get a defensive unit to stand there? Let's do that. Orders. Can I not? What? There's danger? Where's the danger? Oh. You're scared of that little scout. Okay. Well. Isn't that quaint? Okay. Oh. Ah, yeah, yeah. Let us... We could build the barracks now, or... I actually think probably we need... Is the encampment actually giving us anything? Does an encampment give anything without the buildings inside of it? No. Oh, I mean, it gives trade yields. So it's a question of whether to delay 5 turns in order to build a barracks. Or do we just hit kind of soldier on with soldiers? Do need soldiers. And it's... In 5 turns, the situation could be very dramatically different. So currently I have 2 archers. I need more of a front line right now though, so let's just churn out some warriors. You cannot be serious. Okay, now, writing, I think. Yeah. Is that a monument? Yeah. Probably coming too late. Okay, good. Getting a great people points. Ah, yeah, we are actually getting great general points now. Sun Tzu. Okay. Now, prophets. We're not hugely interested in that. Actually, that's fairly useless. Disregarding culture. That's not good. Yeah, that's fairly useless. That could be useful. Especially as we're playing with this district strategy, so it certainly could be useful. What have been previously recruited? Just some great prophets. Okay. Another warrior? Actually, now, given that I'm not actually seeing them come out that off much, so I guess I can actually defend until I get my thing happening. Send Ogun housing issue. Kyoto certainly does. We could... Why don't you build a settler? That's... a good plan. Because as I've said, we do want to expand and make sure that we don't get left behind in terms of... In terms of size, obviously we're much smaller than everyone else. And we are always going to be much smaller until we start winning with our superior kind of tactics and skills. They are not going to like me having troops on their borders, are they? Does that still count as rainforest? Yes, it does. Next, you want to go to... Actually, yeah, you've just unlocked chocolate. Get that chocolate. Okay. Which Cleopatra is this? Orange. Slightly more worrying if Orange gets annoyed at us. Yep, it is. Not. Okay, let's... What is next on our radar? Don't need sailing. Astrology does lists of stuff we don't need. Currency is the next kind of step in our educated path. So yeah, let's just go that, and well, eventually, yeah. I mean, apprenticeship is very, very good. Possibly my favorite tech in the tech tree. Because it makes all your minds better, turns your minds from plus one production to plus two production. So obviously that's a huge deal. And then also you get industrial zones, which give you even more production, and you can put workshops in your industrial zones to get even more production, and you start getting great engineer points, and yeah, it's got a good boost requirement, which I'm surprised I haven't unlocked yet. Like three mines, surely I've already got three mines. And that leads to education, and I believe it boosts a maybe it doesn't. Yeah, maybe not. Case. I'm surprised I haven't got that unlocked yet. Have I really only met two sea states? That is sad. Would have met three if only a certain civ hadn't killed them all. I'm gonna actually just point my guy in a direction and actually find another sea state, because I do want to find that soon. Yep. Is that what I'm doing? Yes. Good. Oh. That was what I was thinking of changing. So, I've got two mines. Where could a third mine be? Can I give a mine to Sendai? I don't think there are any... Unless I bought those hills over there, I don't think I can give Sendai a mine yet. Kyoto would require... Well, firstly, I'm actually gonna send you over there in that case. Unless I did... Thebes isn't ever going to take that territory? Yeah, Thebes is never going to take that. But still, on the other hand, do I really want a random Egyptian city? They could plonk a random Egyptian city around there, and that would not be nice. So... And what is currently the situation in terms of production? Oh, so Sendai actually has some good work tiles in terms of production. Not sure where it's coming. Okay. That's okay. Why has Kyoto got such worse. Oh, plus 13, okay. Why did I think they had a lower number? In any case, Kyoto. Personnel. So we're going to settle in there. Then we're going to invade Jakarta if we get enough strength. This is probably a good time to do some final purchases and then get out of here. I do really want that mine buff. I don't think, like, yeah, that's 140 gold. That's not, we don't have 140 gold. We will in a few turns. What about Kyoto? Is there anywhere that I actually really need to buy? I don't really need to buy any tiles. Actually, what the hell is going on here? Okay, yeah. Good. Ooh, I could buy that one. That's within our budget. We're pretty silly, but yeah, but we need the mind buff. Actually, no, let's just not worry about that. Let's can buy another time. This is actually the bigger issue. Get some builders out. And we can swap into conscription next time. Yeah, we do actually need to pump builders, so that's all fine. And hopefully within 9 turns I've found a new city state. Hopefully. Let's go this way. Oh, that's the coast. That was the wrong way to go. Okay, Shinto is founded. Which Japan founded Shinto? Ooh, Shinto is really good. Sires and Rakdet. extent. Who owns Sires and Rakadat? Oh my god. Oh my god. Hatred of burning of a thousand suns is about to be inflicted upon people. Yeah, so I'm gonna crush some people. If they foolishly declare war on me, I am gonna crush them and I'm gonna destroy their cities, because this is not how you treat Japan. You do not do such blatant land grabbing. I am... could do that, but I'm not doing that. I am... now that I've finished my thing, I'm gonna just churn out some tough guys. Ah, it's those people who have created Shinto. I'm not sure if my new settler is going to have any space to settle in. But it does reinforce my desire to build a settler, to grab some land of my own. Now. How close are we to needing the boost? Oh god, really? That's lime green Cleopatra. Lime green Cleopatra has some big... lime green Cleopatra may be the big deal on this continent. Build an archer. Build another archer. Now, where do I want this archer to go? Probably... is that a mountain? I mean, a hill, yes. That's a hill. So let's put you there. I thought you were meant to start with some experience. Interesting. I really thought that district... oh, what's going on here? Barracks. Oh, gods. Okay. Yeah. Plus 25% comp experience. Unless they've moved the experience bar somewhere. Which, I'm not going to say no to them moving the experience. No, the experience bar is still there. So why is it plus 25% experience? I don't get any experience here. I'm not enthused by this situation. Are we going to build those fast enough? Also, what is required for apprenticeship then? Oh, you need horseback riding as well. Let's do that. Is that the case? Yeah, that's the case. Yes. I assume... Yeah, okay, both of those. Does it actually say? Yeah, currency and horseback riding. Let's do that. It needs orders. Come on, find me a city state. Who is this? It is Lime Green. Well, we're working on a military Lime Green because we want to kill you. Is now the time for warriors? Is 4 archers enough? I don't think 4 archers is enough. So I've got someone there who can fortify. So is that the right decision? Might be better to place you up here. So I can't really do that. So I guess it is there. Anyway. Okay. Oracle has been built. Islam has been built. Ah, yeah, well, we're gonna have another city to defend in a second, so. Need to think about this in terms of that. Situation, we need to move some archers westwards. Still trying to find this elusive city-state, and you are building builders. Oh wow. Yes. That is what you were doing. Unless we go for that. Let's just continue building our route. Hmm. So apart from building lots of units and hopefully fighting them back, if they do end up fighting us. Okay, I really need to move that guy because he's in a... powerful position. Actually, yeah, let's just stick them there for now. And you need to go... probably there-ish? Where are the sea states? So at this point, maybe we could branch into buying some, building some more encampments, or we just keep on warrioring up. Yeah, just keep on building warriors. I think we've got a massive overlap going on here, because... have an overflow problem. Yeah, let's keep on keeping on. Actually, yeah, we need to reinforce the east. Okay, finally. Finally we've met another one. Surely that... is that really the case that I have to know three sea states? I need to meet another city state now because I've actually met three. But one of them doesn't exist anymore. The game checks based on how many sea states you know, rather than how many you've met. Well, that's a problem. Is there any way to... it's not going to yield us anything. Probably try moving there. So, settle to the north, which is actually okay, because there isn't anything really in the way. Could do that. We want somewhere that's ideally... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And they're all going to be out of the Sendai, Tokyo kind of... yeah, there's all these mountain ranges in the way. That's the problem. Could have made one down here that would have got in on the same stuff. But sadly, Egypt has other plans. So, this maybe need to be a more self-reliant operation. And if I settle at either of those places, I do actually have a full, like, well, mostly full hex to go with. But then there's these horses. The horses really want me to ride them, obviously. Maybe I could live without the horses, but anyway. Okay, some more places. That's a bad Egyptian warrior. Well, Northwestern Egyptian warrior. I think they are OG generation Egyptians. OG generation. Original generation Egyptians. Let's just see what is here. Nothing. More warriors? Oh, actually, given that I've got that. How much production do you have? We have got an overflow of production right now. Might want to just dump it on a builder. And then go back to warriors. So, of the people who still exist, Jakarta is the worst suzerain bonus. Now go back to warriors. Oh, that's Sendai. Sendai, don't build warriors, build builders. Or we could build granaries. Yeah, let's build builders. Okay, so where would you suggest? So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Ah, no. Can't get the factory bonus there. We could get another. If we had a city around here and a city around there, then they could put their districts in a giant mess together. In fact, that's a probably even better place for a giant mess of districts. It is a better place for a mess of giant district. Giant mess of districts. Maybe Kyoto should dedicate its districts up here and then have... Ooh. That's some good arguments. Those are some good arguments. If Kyoto had their campuses... say, like, campus and holy sites around here, and then we had all these all this mess of districts, of maybe three cities worth of districts, and then we could leave Sendai as a self-sufficient thing, because it's, well, firstly, it has lots of mountains for its own campus, but also, it has a lot of resources. There's a point to Sendai in terms of just resources, and it's a rich place. It's got all this stuff. I should really stop them getting that chocolate as well. That actually seems like an argument. Start up there first or down here first? There's the horses. And on that note, we're not going to get that chocolate unless we... Wait, so we're not going to get those horses unless we get the goat land here. If we want a river tile. And do we want a river tile? Maybe we do. Well, probably do. I think we get the chocolate. If we put a settler on the top of the chocolate, it will be fine. Where are we putting this mine? May need to purchase tiles. Unless there's somewhere else we could put a mine. could have put mines there if we decide to settle up there first. Unless not, you need to switch into a settler, I think. Need to get that settler as soon as possible. And Kyoto is churning out warriors so fast that we will be able to defend ourselves. Almost certainly. Can we prioritize production here? Is that going to do anything? No, it's not going to. Go there. Go back. Come on, give me a new city-state to visit. Might there be a city-state up there? I'm not sure, probably not. No. I'll stick here. So this is a gamble. Doing this does overextend ourselves. It's a lot harder to defend. This is so many mountains, so many rainforests. Very easy to defend. Very easy to turtle up here. But if we turtle up, then we don't. We limit our expansion. We need to expand out. We need to get bigger. We need to have more cities. So that we can compete adequately. Oh. Oops, sorry. What is going on here? Ah, okay, so I told you to go to the place that the... Come on. Good. Okay, so is that a hill? Yes. And you can go there. Mr. Builder, actually first of all we need to set the production, and that is back to warriors. Mr. Builder can go didn't realize we even had that there. Didn't realize we hadn't built on it. Okay. Now, in terms of outrageously stupid things to do. Let's just guarantee that we get the horses. And what are you up to? What do you build? Let's put you on monument mode. Shall we say to prioritize food? Maybe. What is that? Is that Tokyo? Okay, so now we've got Tokyo. And probably for now, fortify there. Probably gonna fortify along this line eventually, but right now, these are good enough. Defend that pass. Very important position there. Do I have an... Oh, don't have enough gold to buy that now. Anyway. We'll deal with it. Okay. Well, yeah. Well, which one is this? I can't promise that because I'm going to settle near you again. I'm not going to make promises I can't keep. Because if I'm selling there, that will be close to them as well. Orange. Yes, I can promise that I'm not going to settle next to you. Because unless you randomly conquer somewhere around there. Okay. Continue piling up units. So maybe tell you to go there. And you to go there. Okay. I hate when it jumps to something, but anyway. Don't have the money to... Now you're going on automated because it doesn't matter if you find a sea state or not. These civilizations, I like how there's so many rivers on this. I'm liking that fact that there are so many rivers. I'm liking the fact that all these civilizations are kind of... Here is this river civilization, like whatever river we call it. Let's call it the Western River because it's on the west. So you have the Western River Civilization of Egypt, who have surprisingly few cities, like 3 cities. Make a deal, give me your cities, okay, yeah, so they have 3 cities. And you've got the desert people of Orange. What, they're not even desert, I think that's tundra. So yeah, you've got the kind of the plains and tundra people who don't have a river, but they live over here, and then they have branched into there as well. And then you've got the key lime Egyptians who knows what they have, but evidently I think they've settled on this river and then they've jumped over to that river. And then you've got my civilization, which is kind of situated on... Does that make any sense? So that's the source of the river? Is there? And the river flows... No, that's flowing that way. Okay. I think. Oh, okay. Okay, that makes more sense. So this river is flowing down... flowing up here, and this bit is flowing from there, and they meet here. And then it flows out into this river, where so it meets the Key Lime River and flows in. So that's the Red River, and you might even think that that might still be the Red River, maybe. But that actually seems like it's going somewhere else. And here's another river that's just pops up, so the springs there, and then that flows that way. Interesting. So yeah, lacking the rivers. But having just settled Tokyo, which is about to get invaded by Shintoists, I think we should wrap it up. Just for the interests of brevity. I really do want to stop myself having too much production overflow. What do I currently have? Do I have an amount of production that's just waiting there? Because I don't think... Yeah, I think I'm losing production this way, but anyway. That's what happens when you're just spamming units. And units that aren't getting any experience. I built a barracks. What's the point of the barracks if you're not getting experience for that? Unless it's all in the background. Like, I don't see until you actually do some fighting. But, anyway. Till next time, enjoy the internet. And have fun.